$1,000.
If I had $1,000,000,
buy you furniture for your house.
Maybe a nice Chesterfield or an ottoman.
And if I had $1,000,000,
if I had $1,000,000,
well, I'd buy you a K car,
a nice Reliant automobile.
And if I had $1,000,000, I'd buy you.
Be rich. Sen!
Come on, I'm on.
Yeah.
it's G. Ready, play. Big sound, Travis. Bigger, nice, good sound.
Thank you.
Confederate flag.
Thank you.
water. Imagine. Imagine, right?
firework. Play for me the effort on the band real quick and listen up. Here we go. One, two, ready,
thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Marauder Stadium. Our commencement exercises will begin in a few moments. I have a couple of announcements that may help ensure a memorable and enjoyable evening. Remember, this is a formal high school event, and there is a high expectation for audience behavior. Feel free to applaud and celebrate the graduate's success, but keep your cheering appropriate. Please refrain from carrying on conversations and moving from your seat during the formal speeches. A professional photographer will be taking two pictures of each graduate as they are presented their diplomas. Kindly stay in your seats. A reminder, there is no smoking on school grounds, and please be courteous and turn your cell phones off during the ceremony. We will begin our 2023 commencement exercises in a few moments. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Jessica Schultz, and I am the principal of Carlson High School. I want to welcome you all to the graduation ceremony of the 58th graduating class of Oscar A. Carlson High School, and am proud to present to you the class of 2023. I apologize, I think I may have left the heat on. It's pretty hot. At this time, I'd invite everyone to please rise, and gentlemen, to please remove your hats. The class of 2023 has invited the members of the senior choir to sing the national anthem and Carlson High School alma mater.
So
Please be seated. Great job, you guys sounded awesome. As we begin this evening's ceremony, I want to take a moment to welcome our Board of Education, distinguished leaders in the community, district administrators, teachers, and to give a special welcome to the parents and families who have joined us this evening to celebrate this momentous occasion, the class of 2023's graduation. On stage with me this evening is the Gibraltar School District Superintendent, Ms. Amy Conway, and the Gibraltar School District Board of Education President, Mr. Edward Camilleri. I'd like to also introduce other Board of Education members who are present tonight, and if you would please stand when you're introduced. First, Mr. Paul Panter, Vice President, Ms. Pam Franklin, Treasurer, Ms. Christy Conroy-Hines, Secretary, Ms. Candace Langmeyer, Trustee, Mr. Mike Morris, Trustee, and Ms. Paula Warren, Trustee. Also joining us this evening are several civic leaders from our communities. Leaders, please stand as we recognize you as well. Trustee of Brownstown Charter Township, Mr. Stephen Allen. Ms. Maureen Brinker, Brownstown Charter Township Clerk. Mayor of Rockwood, Mr. Daniel Guzzi. And Mayor of Woodhaven, Dr. Patricia Odette. I would also like to take a moment to recognize our GSD staff who have joined us this evening. If you are a member of the GSD staff, please stand at this time. Each and every one of you have played a tremendous role in the students' lives who are sitting here, and we thank you for that. At this time, I'd like to introduce the superintendent of Gibraltar School District, Ms. Amy Conway, to share her remarks with the class of 2023 and members of the audience.
Good afternoon, guests, alumni, teachers, administrators, and graduates. This year, I'm extremely honored to be introducing the 58th graduating class of Oscar A. Carlson. As your superintendent, I have witnessed many wonderful accomplishments from this truly dynamic graduating class. Each year, graduates are told that they will be challenged as they enter their new phase of life, whether it's going away to college, entering a trade, the armed forces, or the workforce. You will have to deal with the unknown and the difficult. The good news is you are ready for what lies ahead because you have already experienced the challenges of high school. You are better prepared for what the world is going to throw at you. These last 4 years have only made you stronger, and now is the time to take on your future with confidence. This fall, our senior class will proudly represent their strengths, abilities, and talents at many college, trade schools, academies, and military schools. I am extremely proud of the wide range of talents and commitments many of you have made for your future. But what is more amazing is the 64 colleges or trades that you will represent this fall. And I want you to think about that, 64. 64 different institutions of higher education that our Carlson students are attending this fall, colleges that are as far south as University of Tampa and Hillsborough Community College, as far west and north as the University of Minnesota and Northern Michigan University, and as far east as Harvard University. We also have a student attending school in Finland next year. This year, we have so many students who are entering apprenticeships and trade programs such as HVAC, pipe fitting, welding, electrician, automotive repair, EMT, and aviation, just to name a few. Truly outstanding. Additionally, we have students joining the Marines, Army, Army National Guard, Police, and Fire Academies. We have seniors that will be playing college level sports in bowling, rolling, softball, hockey, cheer, baseball, soccer, and football. And to make it even more exceptional, our seniors have earned over $6.8 million in scholarship monies due to their academic achievements and talents. Woo! Fantastic. So this all means that our Carousel seniors will be sharing their knowledge, passion for learning, leadership skills, and of course their Marauder pride with people not only throughout the country, but the world. This to me is an accomplishment that I myself and everyone watching here today should be proud of, as you, the graduating class of 2023, is putting Carlson High School on the map as alumni. I want that to sink in, alumni of Carlson. You will be the positive influencers and the difference makers in the world. As I think about this group of accomplished young people, I can't help but be proud of all of you. But before we celebrate you, we must celebrate the people who helped you get to this day. Since your first day of kindergarten in 2010, your parents, friends, mentors, neighbors, and many teachers have encouraged you to keep going when things got difficult. They are the people in the trenches who do the hard work, the people who wouldn't let you sleep in on a day of school, wouldn't let you go out with your friends the night before a big test, told you to put your phone down, stop making TikToks, and do your homework, and sometimes the people who held you after class to make sure you understood what you learned that day. They wouldn't let you give up, and they pushed you to be something more, to be a graduate. I would like to recognize all the special people in each of our seniors' lives and thank you for making this senior class a class to remember. So congratulations, we are proud of you and we wish you all the best in your future endeavors and we can't wait to hear all that you accomplish in the future. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Ms. Conway. This evening, we will hear from two of our top students, beginning with our valedictorian. At this time, I would like to welcome our first speaker, our valedictorian, Ms. Sia Patel, for the valedictory farewell remarks. Sia is the daughter of Sanjay and Reshma Patel. She will be attending the University of Michigan Ann Arbor in the fall, majoring in business administration. Sia says that her favorite high school memory was being a part of homecoming court her senior year.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome. I am so incredibly honored to be up here today. I'd like to begin by expressing my heartfelt gratitude to all those who have supported our every step to reach this esteemed day. The teachers that shaped us, the family that raised us, and our friends that were simply the glue holding everything together. To my fellow graduates, we made it! We've dreamt of this day for as long as we can remember, with the anticipation coursing through our veins and the year 2023 ingrained in our minds. But as the end slowly began to near, that anticipation fused with bittersweetness and sadness. The days that we forever longed to pass by transformed into a countdown of our memories. The smallest of moments became considerably more memorable as we realized that they would be our last together. We grew up. Lucky for us, this is not the end of our journey, rather it has just begun. In this moment right now, we stand at the edge of infinite potential. Allow yourselves to bask in the fact that we will never be brimming with such ample opportunity as we are right now. While our lives have been largely drawn out for us up to this point, ahead lies a blank canvas, and it is up to us to truly paint out our future. That being said, welcome the change, take the risks, live your life wholeheartedly, and unapologetically be yourself while doing it. But most importantly, remember to embrace both the highs and the lows, because as Taylor Swift says, if you never bleed, you're never going to grow. I am so incredibly proud of the class of 2023. That includes you too, Mr. Rice, or should I say Dr. Rice? But sincerely, our class has undoubtedly proven to be one that is beyond compare. We should be so immensely proud of our hard work and accomplishments. I truly cannot wait to see where each of our paths will lead and all the great things we will continue to achieve. Though we don't know what our future truly holds, I'm confident that each of us will have an undeniable, permanent impact on our world. That being said, let's make the next chapters of our lives ones to remember, just like the chapter we are finishing today. Be bold, be passionate, dream big, and always treat people with kindness. Slow down and enjoy the smallest of moments because it will be over before we know it. Congratulations, class of 2023. We made it. Thank you.
Thank you, Sia. Good evening, graduates. So each week, try every day for 4 years here at Carlson, except for the weird ones on Zoom and the entire month of testing each year where it's oddly quiet in school. I get on the PA for the pledge and greet you all with the same words. So for the last time in your high school career, let me wish you a happy Friday. And this time, let me add happy graduation day. I could not be more grateful for the opportunity to be standing here, joined by countless number of people who love and support you, to celebrate the closing of one part of your journey and share our best wishes for what lies ahead. When I thought about what to say to the class of 2023, I thought about the self-assuredness that so many of you have demonstrated going after your individual path, and how, despite the challenges of 4 very different years of high school, you managed to come together through your flexibility, hard work, and perseverance. As your principal, I've had the honor of witnessing your unique spirit firsthand. I mean, in a hilarious turn of events, I found out from you that CHS was for sale. And although the description was well written, it did not include whether I still had my job as part of it, so I wasn't sure. Seriously though, as I thought about what to say tonight, I thought about using the tried and true pieces of advice like follow your dreams and find a job you love and you'll never have to work a day in your life that have been carrying countless high school principals through a graduation speech, and they're pretty successful because they're pretty much true. But your class doesn't need cliches because you're anything but typical and are actually the epitome of embracing your individuality. So here it goes. The class of 2023 is a reminder to all of us that if we can embrace who we are and bring with it the confidence of knowing our strengths and challenges, we are already ahead in the battle. As a class, you have truly embraced your individuality while creating a space where everyone can be their authentic selves. This class embodies a laid-back spirit, providing a breath of calm amidst a chaotic world. You have excelled academically, on the field, and within the community, and have done this in ways that honor your individuality. Through it all, you have made me laugh, made me proud, made a couple more gray hairs sprout on my head, but my stylist is okay, and most of all, helped me remain hopeful. Hopeful in the inevitable positive mark that you will leave on this world. So as I was thinking about what I wanted to say to you this evening, I started thinking about sitting in that very seat almost 25 years ago. I was aged myself right there. And the plans that I had carefully laid out before me. I was super sure of my plans, committed to following through because that's just what you do. I would become a lawyer, move to a big city and get married and definitely not have kids, and even if I did, it wasn't going to be before 30. I had made plans for my whole life to be elevated. Perhaps that is you sitting out there, or you are the one that is just planning for the meal that you're having after graduation. What has happened in the years since graduation has taught me that when people say life is what happens to us when we're busy making plans, they are totally right. Sometimes we can be so focused on that future story that we're telling ourselves that we forget that life is still going on around us. It is true that whatever you consistently do and say, you become. The interactions you have in the moment, the decisions you make in the present, and the people you connect with now are what shapes you. It's impossible for us to predict how any of these decisions or any one plan will truly pan out. Only to know that if we consistently choose thoughtfulness over thoughtlessness, optimism over pessimism, and progress over complacency, we will live a life richer and more meaningful than we could imagine. And if we collectively do it, we will build a community that is all the better for it. So, the class of 2023, my hope for you is that when you look back 5, 10, 25 years from now, you see that the path that you carefully laid out for your dreams was realized. However, if that path happens to veer off course, understand that you are better for the veers in the road, for it's in those veers and bumps and U-turns that we find out what really matters to us, and more importantly, who we really are. I hope that in those short years, you don't lose that same heart and spirit that you carry with you today, and that your older or even much older self is living a life of love and not a life of fear. In fact, my hope is that you do things that scare you. For some, that might be jumping out of a plane, and others, that might be jumping out of bed. Either way, the scary stuff teaches strength and exercises courage. I hope you learn along the way that worry and regret are the best of friends, and partnering with them won't change a mistake or prevent it. My final and greatest hope is that by this time, you recognize what I know to be true of you today. What lies behind you and what lies in front of you pales in comparison to what lies within you. Congratulations and best of luck. And now is the moment that you've all been waiting for, the presentation of the diplomas. Ms. Crystal Fowler and Ms. Dawn Wynn, senior class sponsors, will be reading our graduates' names. Members of the top 10 will receive their diplomas first, followed by our graduates in alphabetical order with ladies first in each row. After carefully reviewing each student's record, I certify that the members of the class of 2023 here today have met the graduation requirements of the state of Michigan and the Gibraltar School District. Ms. Conway and members of the Board of Education, I present to you the class of 2023.
Sia Patel. Mala Bhatti. John Hojanowski. Kareem Faz. Matthew Vizacaro. Sienna Roll. Emily Petty. Benjamin Witkowski. Andrew Gia. Haley Evans. Kayla Aranke. Dasani Autry. Emily Bain. Isabella Bianco. Shelby Blaylock. Jalen Bongiorno. Elisa Branham. Jolie Breach. Jocelyn Butt. Cameron Cable. Sienna Caligari. Ivan Neal. Christian Daniel Adkins. Ethan Ayerson. Justin Allison. Dylan Angel. Rafael Arujo. Darius Osberry. Robert Badilla. Brandon Bell. Cameron Bendelo. Eric Blackman. Nicholas Bose. B. Carroll. Adriana Simiat. Ashley Clement. Carly Cooper. Leah Cruz. Shiloh Davis. Caitlin Elizabeth Demers. Taylor DeShields. Brooklyn Desjardins. Madison Dualo. Sydney Evans. Landon Brad. Roy Brady Jr. Aiden Brake. Evan Brado. Jack Brinker. Seth Broughton. Samuel Brown. Omari Carter. Eric Cavell. Anthony Shirelli. Tyler Collier. Jesse Cortez. Molly Fedoroff. Caitlin Lay Fernando. Abigail Fitchek. Jaden Flat. My daughter, Kaden Marie Fowler. Caitlin Fox. Hallie Furcus. Madison Gafford. Nevaeh Garita. Lindsay Goenda. Emma Gauthier. Gauthier. Gracie Hall. Jesse Davis. Josiah Davis. Colin Deskins. Aiden Dietz. James Dowd. Seth Dunlap. Aiden Edwards. Caden Eshelman. Nicholas Etling. Lucas I. Alexander Fabry. Justin Farnsworth. Riley Hall. Jadelyn Haney. Paige Hartzog. Madison Harvey. Olivia Hauser. Jana Marie Higgins. Jocelyn Holt. Nyana Holt. Haley Hook. Emily Hutchison. Kylie Owasco. Shayla Jarvis. Tristan Foley. Aiden Ferguson. Gabriel Figuera. Jason Fisher. Jack Ferensky. Aiden Gallagher. Diesel Preston Gessner. Jordan Gill. Caleb Greer. McCullen Green. Chase Gritton. James Gruno. Hannah Jordan. Sophia Jordan. Isabella Kalis. Alyssa Cam. Chloe Coke. Madison LeBeau. Macy Renee Lizat. Gloria Lakmani. Cameron Lyon. Sirwiwan Masaling. Emma Marcus. Macy Matthews.
Matthew Hall. Omar Hamden. Thomas Hamilton. Nicholas Hanser. James Hartzog the Fourth. Xavier Hayes. Tristan Haynes. Devon Michael Huff. Avery Alexander Hunter. Lieutenant Nicholas Ivy. Tristan Ivy. Morgan Maynard. Madison McCoy. Camila McMiller. Emma Michael. Tierra Mahalik. Robin Miller. Stevie Lynn Miller. Allie Miley. Jordan Monroe. Allison Neese. Gracie Norton. Madeline O'Connor. Landon Jackson. Antonio Alexander Jazerski. Curtis Johnson the Second. Dewan Johnson. Nathan Johnson. Brenner Johnston. Bradley Kaiser. Austin Keith. James King Jr. Jaden Gage Knox. Isaac Colasa. Zachary Laferrette. Olivia Odell. Rachel Azia Omar. Olivia Yvette Osinek. Lindsay Wren Paulson. Brooke Polizeski. Katya Pejcic. Felix Marie Phillips. Christine Piat Bakos. Rachel Poli. Gianna Pritchard. Iman Rajput. Meredith Ricosi.
Edward Light the Fourth. Cole Lindstrom. Bradley Matika. Aiden Malik. Nicholas Manolius. John Manulian the Fourth. Jake Manich. Timothy McBride Jr. Jonathan McCullough. Teddy Mendoza Jr. Brendan Mitchell. Christopher Myers Jr. Ariel Rasmussen. Alyssa Regora. Cadence Reynolds. Mackenzie Richardson. Elizabeth Roberts. Ava Romay. Cheyenne Adeline Roy. Hadley Sanders. Abigail Shinabar. Brielle Shaw. Brooklyn Ann Shemwell. Kaylee Sondheim.
Aiden Nagy. Gabriel Nichols. Ty Okarinen. Bradley Owens. Carlson Perini. Matthew Pogorski. Hayden Poplin. Van Price. Dylan Joseph Prickett. Benjamin Pristula. Haydar Rajput. Nicholas Reach the Fourth.
Chloe Spear. Caitlin Sprinkles. Avery St. Andre.
Regan Steck. Leah Stith. Skylin Stoos. Alexa Straub. Tara Subiak. Ellen Zooks. Madison Taylor. Gabriella Thiessen. Olivia Toko. Andrew Reed. Jordan Reese. Seth Reese. Nathan Reeves Jr. Ethan Romero. Austin Rosinski. Logan Sampson. Brandon Scheffler.
Oh yeah, B-Chef.
Jack Sheridan. Timothy Simons Jr. Zachary Sisk. Andrew Smith. Madison Toombs. McKenna Trent. Madison Nicole Valdez. Jada Van Avery. Leah Walzak. Ever May Webb. Jasmine White. Lauren Elizabeth Wilkins. Brianna Williams. Emily Winters. Jada Woodley. Abby Woodring. Caitlin Wada. Skylar Zarenka. Smith. Jamil Smith. Kobe Smith Jr. Quentin Smith. Dalton John Snyder. Dylan Spano. Jacob Steinert. Joshua Strusky. Dylan Swinney. Zachary Thomas. Jaden Toma. Jovan Toma. Joseph Truex. Landon Turner. Owen Usselton. Zachary Walder. John Wallace II. Robert Walter. Mason Washam.
Ready?
Jaden Weber. Brett Witten. Jake Williams. Amar Yasser.
That was just for effect, I think. So one more time, congratulations to our class of 2023. I would now like to call to the stage our salutatorian and senior class president, Mr. Mala Bhatti, who will share some closing remarks for the senior class and lead the class of 2023 through the turning of the tassels. Mala is the son of Talat and Zile Bhatti and plans to attend the University of Michigan Ann Arbor. Mala says that his favorite memory of high school is pouring water on Mr. Georgie during the polar plunge.
Thank you, Ms. Schultz. Graduates, how are we doing? All right. We did it. We accomplished a major milestone in our life. We worked hard to get to this day, and our work will not go to waste. So let's get an applause for all the graduates again. We may have crossed the graduation stage, but our achievement is a testament to the unwavering support and guidance of our parents. Without them, we couldn't have reached this milestone in our lives. Thank you to our parents for always being there. Mom, Dad, I love you. As we express our deepest gratitude to our parents for their unwavering support, let us also extend our appreciation to our dedicated teachers and mentors who have played a pivotal role in shaping our journey. Thank you to all the teachers and staff at Carlson High School and throughout the school district, with a special mention to Ms. Wynn and Ms. Fowler. You have been the best class sponsors we could have asked for. We apologize for any difficulties we may have caused. And I'm personally sorry for listing our school on Facebook Marketplace. If it makes you feel better, my account did get suspended. Also, a big thank you to all the staff and teachers that put the extra time in to ensure the best experience for us as students, in your classrooms and out. I personally want to thank some teachers, Ms. Begman and Ms. Plose. Your impact extends far beyond the classroom. You have consistently gone above and beyond your roles to offer guidance, support, and inspiration. Mr. Harris, Mr. Warren, and Mr. Gervasi, thank you for your words of encouragement, genuine belief in my abilities, your roles as educators, and for being influential mentors who have motivated me to reach new heights. Last but not least, I would like to express my sincerest gratitude to Ms. McLean, Mr. Danick, and Mr. Georgie for their incredible ability to make every class engaging and captivating. Their passion for teaching, innovative teaching methods, and dynamic classroom environments have transformed learning into a truly enjoyable experience. Your influence has been incredibly meaningful. Teachers like you bring positivity to our school and make going to school worthwhile. Well, graduates, we made it. Street philosopher and poet Drake put it best. We started from the very bottom, and now it looks like the whole team's here. Just think about how far we've come, individually and as a class. Looking back to freshman year, it seems like it was just yesterday. There was the first football game, the first class, the first test you failed, the second test you failed. We had a test today? The first time being sent home due to some virus. Looking back on those days, it's incredible to see growth and transformation we've undergone as individuals and as a class. We've endured the ups and downs, the successes and setbacks, and we've learned valuable lessons along the way. We've overcome many obstacles, like standardized testing, a global pandemic, and some of us have even lost a tooth to a calculator. All just to get to this day. We've grown not only academically, but also personally, discovering our passions, interests, and talents along the way. We've formed lifelong friendships and forged connections who've left a lasting impact on us. We've written our story. The class of 23 was undoubtedly been one of the most outstanding classes in Carlson history. We've accumulated a total of $6.8 million in scholarship money. And just this year alone, our athletic programs have brought home 7 championship titles. Our various student organizations outdid themselves and proudly represented our school. We have achieved remarkable success. Our hard work, determination, and resilience have paved the way for numerous accomplishments. From academic excellence to extracurricular achievements, as we embark on the next chapter of our lives, the class of 23 can be proud of our accomplishments and confident in our ability to thrive in whatever field. To my fellow graduates, you are all destined for greatness. Each and every one of you has the potential to change this earth. I ask that you follow your dreams and do what makes you happy. Strive to be the best versions of yourself. Embrace the challenges that come your way. Navigate through difficulties and fully embrace life's experiences. Strive for greatness or risk being forgotten. Before we part ways and embark on our new journey, I want to leave you with a quote. Nietzsche said, "The fact that something seems impossible shouldn't be a reason not to pursue it. That's exactly what makes it worth pursuing. Where would the courage and greatness be if success was certain and there was no risk? The only true failure is shrinking away from life's challenges." May you all embark on your journeys with unwavering determination, and may you find success in the pursuit of the great and impossible. Now, being the generation that likes to document everything, I would ask Ms. Schultz if she would do the honors of recording this moment. Graduates, on the count of three, for the last time together, move your tassels from the right side of your cap to the left. 1, 2, 3. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Joke's on Mala. I'm not that great of a videographer. Well, this concludes this evening's ceremony. Teachers, please move to your designated areas.
Any teachers or staff in the audience who would like to join our staff should come to the track now. Audience, please remain seated as our graduates recess and get their diplomas over by the visitors' concession stand. Thank you and have a wonderful evening.
here behind Vaughn. All the stands get flipped over and put in the rack, and the alto saxophone section is in charge of taking the racks back to the band room. Okay, all the percussion, I'll bring the trailer over here. We're gonna load her up then. All the water bottles get put back in the coolers, even if they're empty. Put it in the cooler. Yeah? Let's go.
Let's go down.